Hello friends, welcome to 45 Solution. So today we take a case study and we'll see how an individual or a company who indulge in forgery and piracy, or you can say data breach, will be charged under IT Act or IPC Act. So we take a case study. Now let's take an example, and suppose there is one company called Dipanjali Hospital and there is another company called Ashish Tech. Now this Ashish Tech is having a vast experience in hospitality service industry, and because of this credential, Dipanjali Hospital given him a AMC contract. Now what does AMC contract stand for? This is annual maintenance contract, and in that Ashish Tech need to do the system maintenance, update and troubleshooting. But there was one provision in the contract that was NDA. Dipanjali Hospital had signed a NDA with Ashish Tech. Now what this NDA stand for? This NDA stand for non-disclosure agreement. Now what terms of non-disclosure agreement is this? That whatever details, data or source code shared by Dipanjali Hospital with Ashish Tech, in that case the Ashish Tech will share those data only with those or specific employees who are part of this contract. Okay, and they're not supposed to disclose this details or data with third party. Okay, and this agreement validity is for 5 years, so they have to maintain this privacy for 5 years. So what happened during course of this execution of this contract, and there was a Mr. Vijay who was one of the lead member of this contract, who resigned from Ashish Tech and opened his own venture or his own company, let's say that's called New Tech Company. Okay, and definitely he also, because he's from the same domain, so he also having great experience in hospitality service industry, and he got a contract from Abhishek Hospital, similar type of contract what he done with Ashish Tech. Okay, that's called AMC contract. And what happened during his contract, New Tech given the know-how or data to Abhishek Hospital, or you can say data breach. And definitely somehow this Dipanjali Hospital had came across with the data breach. The data breach has been happened, and they came to know that this New Tech had done this because of or through Mr. Vijay. Okay, now just for a more clarity, this Abhishek Hospital and Dipanjali Hospital both are competitor with each other, because they both are working in same locality and in same industry. Now what happened? So this Dipanjali Hospital did a police complaint against New Tech and Mr. Vijay, and they both were charged under IT Act as well as IPC Act. Okay, now we'll see which are the sections of IT Act as well as IPC Act will be applicable to Mr. Vijay as well as his company called New Tech. Now first we look at the IT Act. Now IT Act having given us three sections which will be applicable in this scenario or in this case study. The section called 43. Now because what happened, he steal the computer source and data from Dipanjali. Now Mr. Vijay, while working with the Ashish Tech, he definitely came across with the data which Dipanjali Hospital shared with Ashish Tech. So he steal those data, and based on that he provided this data to Abhishek Hospital. So definitely this section 43 will be applicable to him, or he will charge under this section 43. Then section 65, because Mr. Vijay signed the NDA with Ashish Tech that he'll maintain or maintain the secrecy or secure the source code or data which he'll receive from Deepanjali for the 5 years, and he breached the contract, and because of that he will charge under this section 65. And section 66 also will be applicable, as this is a computer related offense, because there is a dishonesty and involved, or you can say that Mr. Vijay as this company New Tech was involved in unlawful activity, because he shared the data and provided the patent product or patent system of Deepanjali Hospital to Abhishek Hospital. Now we'll see how IPC Act will be applicable in this case, or which are the section of IPC code will be applicable. Now there is a illegal activity, because patent product or patent source code has been shared with rival company, so definitely be charged under illegal, and data has been stolen, so they'll be charged under section 379. And definitely he did not comply with NDA, so definitely he will charge under section 408. And section 420 also be applicable, because there is a cheating and dishonesty between the contract. So definitely this four clause of IPC will be applicable to Mr. Vijay or his company, or you can say that Mr. Vijay as well as his company New Tech will be charged under this section 43, 379, 408 and 420. So prima facie we have just gone through it, and if you go in detail of that case, you may be come up with more sections of respective acts, or IT Act as well as IPC Act. Hopefully you have understood what I was trying to explain you, and which are how this sections will be applicable in that particular scenario. That's it for this video. Take care. Rab Rakha.